spend a moment or two together before our day starts. We'll make you aware of an opportunity this weekend called a fight. Saturday night, October the 3rd from 6 to 8 p.m. We're having a truck retreat here in the church. We're at 300 North Central Avenue. I hope you'll be able to join us. All the kids in the course of that dress up in a costume. There's lots of food and lots of fun. We do hope you'll be able to be here with us. I want to tell you a story about Lazarus. There's a couple of different people named Lazarus in the New Testament. This particular Lazarus was a very poor man. He was homeless. He had come to set up camp outside the gate above the home of a very wealthy man, but the really wealthy man just totally ignored him, never gave him any food, never gave him any water or anything. Eventually, both of them died. The wealthy man to a place called Hades, Lazarus to a man to a place called Abraham's bosom. Abraham's bosom was a place of comfort, a place of rest. Hades was a place of burning fire. Read it from Luke chapter 16, verse 24. After he had told him about the rich man, cried out and said, "Father Abraham, have mercy on me and send Lazarus, that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool off my tongue, for I am agony and sweating." But Abraham said, "Child, remember that during your life you received your good things, likewise Lazarus' bad things. But now he's being comforted here, and you are in agony. And besides all this, between us and you is a great chasm, folks, and all of those who may wish to come over here for you may not be able to know the things that are from there to us." You know, the problem that the rich man had, the reason why he was consigned to the burning place of Hades, was not that he was wealthy. That was not the problem at all. The problem was what he had allowed his wealth to do to his heart. His wealth had hardened his heart to people like Lazarus. And so when he cried out to God, saying, "Send Lazarus over here," God said no, because after all, you didn't care anything about Lazarus in life. Why else did you care anything about him in death? And notice that the rich man wanted Lazarus to come. He still saw Lazarus as a servant, as someone beneath him. God said no. You had plenty of opportunities to minister to Lazarus. If your heart had been less hard, you would not be where you are now. And so there you are. Let's remember that all the blessings of God has given us are not for our benefit, but for the benefit of the world around us, the people around us that are hurting. So look around and say, "Where's the Lazarus that I